In the news recently, we've seen that the Russian ruble has dropped dramatically. I thought that would be a good subject to talk about as it related to the U.S. dollars and the fluctuation in value that we see here in the United States. So what does it mean when the value of the U.S. dollar either declines or increases? Well, it refers to the amount of money that you get when you exchange a dollar for another country's currency. When the dollar rises, you get more for your buck. When it decreases, you get less for your dollar. Just like purchasing things overseas, if we have a strong dollar, then purchasing things are a better bargain, especially if you go overseas and you go on vacation, for example. Now, if we have a weak dollar and you're overseas on vacation, you're going to pay more for items as you exchange the dollar for that foreign currency. Now, what about your investments? How does it affect that? Well, investing overseas, I think, is important because it gives you diversification in your portfolio, but you need to consider currency risk. Now, again, same thing here. If the dollar against that currency in which you're looking at falls in value, then the dollar relative to the local currency will increase your return. A rise in the dollar will lower your rate of return, which is kind of opposite than what happens when you actually purchase items overseas. So how do portfolio managers manage currency risk? Well, they do it one of three ways. Sometimes they do nothing at all. They feel that let's not hedge against the currency that we're investing in or that foreign country, and over the long term, things will even out. Some managers feel that it's important to always hedge, so we take that risk out of the portfolio. And a third approach is to decide when to hedge and when not to hedge. Now, deciding what's right for you takes a little bit of effort, and I would recommend that you consult with your financial advisor.